Trump campaign national spokesperson Katrina Pearson joining us from Dallas. Katrina, thanks for taking the time again today.
Thank you, Jim.
So Mr. Trump attacking President Clinton this morning for his affair with Monica Lewinsky, also mentioned Paula Jones. President Clinton, though, is not running for office. His wife is. Why is that attack, why is that affair, fair game?
Well, I don't necessarily call it an attack. It's more of a response to Hillary Clinton bringing up sexism, which is what she plans to do on any Republican that's running against her next year. And I think it is fair game. We're talking about a previous president, a president that has many issues with women. So if Hillary Clinton wants to run with this war on women tactic and calling Mr. Trump a sexist, he's going to defend himself.
Well, explain to me exactly how Hillary Clinton is playing the woman's card. We hear that from Mr. Trump all the time. Explain to me what exactly he means by that.
Well, she called him a sexist outright, number one. And number two, she did it to Bernie Sanders when he talked about people yelling loudly. And she says, well, when a woman speaks, they call it yelling loudly. She's been playing that game since the very beginning, Jim.
But why is that playing the women's card? You know, he has made comments, as you know, that many women have taken as offensive, whether we're talking about the comments about Carly Fiorina's face and others. Why is that a politically motivated response? A lot of women who aren't politicians have said the same thing.
Well, for two reasons. The first reason is Hillary Clinton knows Mr. Trump and knows that he's not a sexist or a racist or a bigot, but yet she still launches those attacks against him. But secondly, he hasn't been sexist and trying to silence women. He speaks his mind and speaks the truth. And if she wants to call that sexism, she's going to have to defend her own reasons for helping her husband hide blatant sexism.
You say Mrs. Clinton knows Mr. Trump well, and this is well documented. They've had a lot of interactions, including at least one wedding attended together. BuzzFeed News just found this blog post from Donald Trump in 2008. We'll put that up on the screen. Writing on his Trump University site, Trump said, quote, I know Hillary, and I think she'd make a great president or vice president. So what's changed since 2008?
Well, I think a lot's changed since 2008. Look at all the Obama supporters that are now running away from the Democrat Party. Time changes everything, Jim, and that's why we're in this position today. We see people looking for alternatives on both sides of the aisle.
But what specifically changed in Donald Trump's appraisal of Hillary Clinton? If he says in 2008 she'd make a great president, and now, of course, he's saying something very different.
Well, if you look at what he's been saying about her now, she's been an absolute disaster. She has proven that she can't handle her job as Secretary of State. That was a failure on a number of issues. But she just really doesn't have anything that she could run on as an accomplishment. She wants to run on old policy. She doesn't want to talk about anything new or anything that she personally had to deal with. On top of the fact that she's under investigation by the FBI for sharing national secrets. I mean, this is absurd. A lot of things have changed since 2008.
Let's talk about where Donald Trump has been directing his attention in the last week or so. We here have noticed a change where Hillary Clinton has popped up more and more often. In fact, I'll show you this. We did a word cloud of his tweets just in the last week. The bigger words are the ones he's used most commonly. And what do you see right in the middle there? Certainly Hillary, but also Jeb Bush. Not to mention Thank and Poll and Great and so on and Make America Great
and
Again.
And
CNN. There you go. We get our plug. But the two biggest, Jeb Bush and Hillary Clinton, why the focus on them right now?
Well, I think both you, for the last few years, we've all been told that this is going to be a Clinton-Bush matchup all over again. Turns out that's not going to be the case. You know, Jeb Bush was the one out there to beat at the beginning. Donald Trump came in and smacked him down, and now it's going to be up against Hillary Clinton. We feel very confident Mr. Trump is going to be the nominee, and he wants to focus on the future.
So why focus on Jeb Bush if he's not a player?
Well, most of it's responding to Jeb Bush at this point. But beforehand, when Mr. Trump entered the race, it was all about Jeb Bush. You're talking about people in the party telling him he needs to get out of the race, telling him he's not a Republican. He's the one that's been bullied this whole time, not Hillary Clinton.
Let's talk about spending now, because we heard Donald Trump just a moments ago saying he's going to spend big in Iowa and New Hampshire, his own money, something that he hasn't done much of so far in this campaign. Can you tell us anything specific about his spending plans? I mean, for instance, has the campaign bought airtime?
I don't know if they've done it yet, but they are definitely planning to spend money in Iowa. And this is normal. We're going into the caucus, and Mr. Trump really wants to get, you know, his vision out there. But more importantly, Mr. Trump's support is solid. This is more to talk to those people who are still undecided. A lot of people in Iowa don't make that decision until they get to that caucus. And so that's really a play for the people that haven't really committed yet.
You know the perception out there, and this is the last one we'll have time for, that the reason he's spending now is he's worried that Ted Cruz's numbers are rising in Iowa. He wants to maintain the lead. How do you respond to that?
No, absolutely not. Mr. Trump is not worried at all in Iowa. We do have significant support in Iowa and a great team in Iowa. Mr. Trump is only going to spend money there to again, get those last-minute voters, because Iowa is notoriously known for people not voting until they get to that caucus. So this is a play to all those people who are undecided, because his support is solid.
Katrina Pearson, Trump campaign, thanks again.
Good to see you, Jim.